watching Knicks Now by Chat Sports. I am your host, Marshall Green. We're going to be answering questions from subscribers on today's video. So if you did not get your question answered, it's your own dang fault. So change it. Two-step process. Subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications. So when we go live next week, you can join us as we do these mailbags live. Shout out to my guy, Flav of Phrase. He actually sent in a $2 super chat. Shout out to you, bro. If Leon's trading Deuce for a five, you got to keep Rokas. I think at this point, Rokas Jokubaitis should be an afterthought for all of Knicks fans and all of Knicks decision makers. Rokas is reportedly going to sign with another team overseas and not come play for the Knicks this season. This video was filmed on July 23rd, so that things could change by the time it gets published. But from what I have heard, there are teams overseas that are heavily pursuing Rokas and want to keep him over there. Look, if he wants to come play for the Knicks, he can come play for the Knicks. He hasn't done it, and he was drafted in 2021. Not going to continue to wait on him. And I think that we already got our backup point guard in Tyler Kolek. Alex Booth, what's up? Marsh, rank these three center targets. Love this. Jalen Duren, Alpren Sengun, or Walker Kessler. Well, Sengun is number one for me. I think by this time next year, everyone will understand why I wanted to trade for Alpren Sengun so bad. I think he's going to be a superstar in this league. I think he'll be an all-star, and we're going to be looking at him in the same light as the other top centers in this league. For me, I'm going to go Walker Kessler, number two, and then Jalen Duren at number three. Kessler, 7'1", Jalen Duren, 7'2". Walker Kessler is one of the best rim protectors in the NBA, and Duren is just not on his level there. Duren's a better scorer. Duren's more gifted offensively, but I think that Tom Thibodeau could take Walker Kessler and in three seasons make him the best defensive center in the NBA behind Victor Wembanyama. Guy averages 2 years in a row, almost three blocks per game in less than 30 minutes a night. Give me Sengun, Kessler, then Duren. I know a lot of people will probably put Duren number two, though. John Thoddy, what's up, man? Thanks for the super chat. When is the Big Daddy move? I think deadline, but that risks injury for trading Mitch and low return value for Randle. Free agency in the summer. Yep. Thoughts? I think we kind of already saw the Knicks' Big Daddy move, right? You gave up four unprotected first-round picks for Mikal Bridges. You gave up another first-round pick that comes from the Milwaukee Bucks. And you gave up a first-round pick swap. So you technically gave up the control of six first-round picks. I'm not sure we're going to see a bigger move than that made by the Knicks this offseason. But, man, like, just keep your eyes on Julius Randle. I'm not saying trading him. I'm not saying don't trade him. Just reading the tea leaves. There's a reason we hear Kat's name all the time. The way you're trading for Kat is if you include Randle. And if Randle doesn't sign that extension, he could be a free agent and leave the Knicks in July of 2025. I think it would be, I would not be doing a good job if we didn't talk about what that could happen. So, yeah, I mean, look, if you, the longer you wait, I think the value goes down for Randle. But, man, like, if a team wants him, they're going to want him and they're going to make a move for him. And I'm not trading him just to trade him. Like, I got to either be getting A, someone better, B, someone younger with a higher ceiling, or C, someone that makes the Knicks better, better fit. I think there's another move coming because I don't think you go all in for OG and McHale to have a center rotation of Robinson, Huck Porty, and Sims. That's just me trying to read it from 5,000 feet out. Rashidi Akins, what's up, bro? Appreciate the love. Happy late birthday to you, man. What do you think will happen with Precious? If I had to say today, I think he's going to re-sign with the New York Knicks. I do think it's interesting that free agency has been open for a month now, and he has not re-signed or signed with another team. Maybe a sign and trade is something the Knicks continue to explore. Maybe that's something we continue to talk about on this channel. But I think it's probably out of 100%, I'll put 60%, Achiuwa re-signs with the Knicks. 25%, it's a sign and trade somewhere else. That would be 85%, and then 15% he leaves in free agency. So more likely than not, I think he re-signs or a sign and trade or he leaves in free agency. 51.5 wins for the Knicks this year. That is the line that the odds makers out west have set for our New York Knicks. For our New York Knicks. Think they're going to win more? Think they're going to win less? Type O for over. Type U for under. I'm going with over. They won 50 games last year and dealt with a lot of injuries. Yes, they lost Hartenstein, but I think they got better by adding Bridges. I'll go over. Julian, since the Payne addition, I see McBride getting moved. Would he, Mitch, in a first and second be enough to acquire Kessler? Yeah, that is plenty enough. As I had a runny nose, excuse me. I wouldn't even give all that up for him, to be honest with you. Like, I was hesitant to do McBride for Kessler straight up. I'm not adding a first and Mitch to acquire Kessler. Like, just not doing it, that's too much for me. That's too rich for my blood. Knicks have two tradable first-round picks. I don't want to give up a first for Walker Kessler if I'm also having to give up Deuce and Mitch. Because then you're, once again, you don't have a backup center unless you're going to sign Achiuwa. Make sure you guys do have our shirt here at Chat Sports. We launched a real one shirt, I think probably 2 summers ago at this point, maybe a year and a half ago. We got a blue one. We got a black one as well. Not a lot of people have the black one. I think it's pretty dang slick. You can get yours today at this link, chatsports.com/realknicks. That's chatsports.com/realknicks. I'll make sure that link is clickable down in the comments and in the description of today's show. NY2AZ, $20 super chat. Shout out to you. That Reggie Jackson signing was a good bench pickup for the Sixers. Knicks and Sixers might be neck to neck. Yeah, the Sixers have had a really good offseason. And they go out and they sign Reggie Jackson. I was going to pull up the 76ers roster at this point. I like the moves they made. They're really deep at the guard spot. So obviously they go out and they get Paul George. They retain Kelly Oubre. They go out and then they sign Caleb Martin. That was a really good deal. They drafted Jerry McCain. They go out and they get Reggie Jackson. They bring back Kyle Lowry. They have Eric Gordon. They have a surplus of guards. I think they may be a little bit small for the Knicks. Are they putting Paul George on Randle for an entire series? On the flip side, I wonder about how Randle guards on the perimeter versus them. Yeah, I mean, look, I think the best three teams in the East are the Knicks, Sixers, and Celtics, and they're all going to be battling for that opportunity to represent this conference. G5 Weez, what's up, man? Should we trade Julius for Capela? No. No, I'm not trading Julius Randle for Clint Capela. No, I'm not doing that. Randle, 2-time All-Star, 3-time All-NBA player. Clint Capela is a starting caliber center in this league that's 30 years old. Capela is a role player. And I think if you're going to win a title, Clint Capela's probably got to be your worst starter. Yeah, I'm not trading Randle for that. The rumor I had heard, Begley mentioned that they checked in on Capela. He also said that it would probably be Robinson going out in that deal, which would mean you probably get Capela, then re-sign Achiuwa or sign and trade Achiuwa. You got to get sticky there with the money. Capela makes like $22 million. You got to send more money out that you're getting money or you're going to hard cap yourself at that first apron. The Knicks just did all that stuff to not be hard capped at the first apron. Nah, I'm not trading Julius for Capela. No chance. Does that make the Knicks better? No, it does not. Nelson, what's up, man? Any news on Thibodeau's contract extension? The only thing I've heard, which we did a video out on the channel yesterday, Nelson, check it out. It was the one about Tom Thibodeau taking a discount, an extension. Also, that was on the back half of one video. I forget what the video was. It was on the Knicks concerned about Julius Randle's fit, according to Ian Begley. Check that video out. But the only thing we've been told is that at Summer League, sounded like it was going to happen. That's what Mark Stein wrote. It's going to happen. I don't have any doubts that'll happen. OG, what's up, man? I don't know if he's available, but I've been kicking around the idea of Dwight Howard. I'm just trying to get a decent center that won't require losing Randle or Deuce. Thoughts? Yeah, I mean, look, if there's a way the Knicks can add a decent center that's a good backup and you don't have to give up Randle and you don't have to give up Deuce, sign me up. Has Dwight Howard... I don't know why I'm calling him Dwight. Has Dwight Howard, has he burned the NBA bridge? I don't know. Because I'm going to be honest with you. I think he still can play. Is he the guy that's on the Magic? No. Is he the guy that's on the Rockets? No. Is he the guy that's on the Lakers? No. But shit, you're telling me if you play Dwight Howard for 15 minutes, he can't block some shots and grab some boards? I got one game to win tomorrow. Who do I want to be my backup center? Dwight Howard or Jericho Sims? It's Dwight Howard. I think he's still got some ball to play. I don't know if the ball to be played is in the NBA. No. Brian Fitzgerald, what's up, man? How can Achiuwa become under? How good can it? I think he's going to continue to get better and better, Brian. I mean, when the Knicks traded for Achiuwa, we saw him each game get better. And when he was with the Knicks, he was solid as a starter when he had to start because of injuries. And we've seen it, Brian. People come to the Knicks and they have the best season of their career playing under Tom Thibodeau. Jalen Brunson, Josh Hart, DiVincenzo, Julius Randle, even guys the Knicks drafted, Deuce McBride, Mitchell Robinson. They sign Isaiah Hartenstein for 2 years, $16 million. He leaves for three for 90. I think that Precious Achiuwa can be a legit bench big for the New York Knicks if he continues to learn and grow under Tom Thibodeau. And he's a little bit undersized to be a full-time five. But I think playing next to OG Anunoby at the four with Mikal Bridges on the four with Hart as well, you can get away with him playing the five. I mean, look, remember when the Knicks beat the 76ers? I believe that was game four. Mitchell Robinson didn't play. The lineup that closed for the Knicks was Achiuwa and OG. And they did a damn good job on Embiid. Yeah, Achiuwa's a small ball five. And he's got lineup versatility. I like the way he plays. I'd bring him back. I don't know what they're waiting for. Maybe a sign and trade. My question to you before we bounce on out of here is, the Knicks win the finals this year if? Fill in that blank for me. The Knicks win the finals this year if? Let me know in the comments. And make sure to hit me up on social media. Trying to grow my presence over there. And I just want to continue to chop it up with all the real ones. So hit me up at Marshall Green _Twitter and IG.